We were staying in Paris to get away from your parents, and I thought, wow, if I could take this in a shot right now, I don't think that we could work this out. Out on a terrace, I don't know if it's fair, but I thought, how could I let you fall by yourself? Well, I'm wasted with someone else.
We have made it to Paris.
Yes. Oh, there's the Eiffel Tower.
Casual. So we actually got in earlier this morning, but our flight was delayed getting in, and then sorting out SIM cards, exchanging money, getting luggage, finding the train station, all that jazz took like 3 hours until we got to our beautiful flat, which I will definitely be including a flat tour in this vlog, or in one of the Paris vlogs, I'm sure. And so, apologize if I'm seeming a little out of it. It's because we haven't really slept in like 24 hours, 36 hours, something like that.
Like 36.
Like 36
hours. We slept
hours.
Like 2 hours in the plane.
We slept like 2 hours on the plane, which wasn't obviously a lot, but we wanted to push through and try to fight the jet lag by staying awake all day today and going to bed normal time tonight. And so we had kind of on our rough itinerary decided to go up into the Eiffel Tower tonight. And so that is what we're gonna be doing, but sun hasn't set yet. But we figured to stay awake, we would just come down here earlier and explore and walk along the Seine, sunset, all nice and romantic.
If we go down, then we go down together. They'll say you could do anything, they'll say that I was clever. If we go down, then we go down together. We'll get away with everything, let's show them we are better. Let's show them we are better. Let's show them we are better. We're staying in Paris to get away from your parents. You look so proud, standing there with a frown and a cigarette, posting pictures of yourself on the internet, out on the terrace. We breathe in the air of this small town on our own, cutting glass with the thrill of it, getting drunk on the past we were living in. If we
made it to the top of the Eiffel Tower. Well, technically the second floor, which I have to say, I think you get a little bit more bang for your buck here because not all of Paris is like high rises like you would see in New York City. A lot of it's low, like 10 to 12 story buildings. And so from the second floor, you can actually see a lot more of the detail, which is why I prefer it. And since it's my second time up here, I'm kind of an expert.
There's a really beautiful view right here.
So what Jeff and I are about to do is something that I did 6 years ago when I came to Paris for the first time, and that is take the stairs back down because you get vistas at like every landing and it's just plain magical. So I highly suggest, you can totally take the elevator up, but take the stairs down because there's just something right about like being, you're inside of the Eiffel Tower. We're inside of the Eiffel Tower right now.
It's just so massive and so
impressive. It's just so massive and impressive, and I just feel like you get to experience it on such a different level and get to actually observe the architecture, the literal nuts and bolts of the tower as you're going down, and you just get really cool vantage points like up into the tower that you wouldn't get otherwise. So like the elevator shaft, for example. So yeah, kind of having a fangirl freak out slash memory sesh right now. Hoofed it down the stairs so that we could see this at 10 o'clock. It's so magical! We got up early this morning, found the most amazing little bakery shop that we will be frequenting a lot this week.
Yes, every
in our
day.
Neighborhood. It's incredible.
They have amazing croissants.
I mean everything. We found like a legit, authentic, traditional patisserie. And so we went to the Musee d'Orsay already. Fun fact of the day, and I've been fortunate enough that both times in Paris, I fell on the first Sunday of the month, or my trip fell on the first Sunday of the month, which means that the museums are free, which is so great. So we can enjoy the Musée d'Orsay today and the Louvre free of charge, which is great, especially because both museums are really large and there's so much to see. And so, I don't know, it's just nice to kind of not stress that we like have to get our money's worth in or spend too long in there all day, that we can just kind of leisurely take our time, which is what we've been doing. And now we are walking through the Tuileries Gardens, which has been on my Paris bucket list for a while, on our way to Angelina for a little lunch and
hot chocolate.
Yeah, what's supposed to be like the world's best hot chocolate. So needless to say, I'm very excited about that.